Okay, so in my humble opinion, things I'm guilty of that I believe are the three worst things you can do with a bass guitar. The worst things, the worst sins, okay? I'm gonna start with number three, okay? I even made some notes. Playing too much. Getting fancy, getting too complicated, okay? We've all probably played with, you know, different guys and different bands, and there's always somebody who needs to stand out, who needs to be brighter and shinier than everybody else, and it sticks out. Excuse my my French, but it sticks out like a sore dick. And it's just a distraction. There's no sense of, you know, it's like, you know, the star player on the basketball team, you know, like, you know, a good, mature and confident musician knows how to listen and play what's right in the context of what's happening and keep their ears open and adapt. I think back to, an experience I had once upon a time where I was playing with somebody and they actually said to me, well, that doesn't sound like, you know, that's not going to be very fun for me to play. And it was because it was some very like simple, like musical idea. And I remember just scratching my head thinking like, you're missing the whole point here. Like you're playing in a band context. Like you gotta be, you play as an ensemble. It's not you. So if you're the kind of person who needs like a lot of spotlight and stuff, the bass is probably not your instrument. Go and pick up, play solo. Grab a guitar and get on an open mic if you need to fulfill that need. One of the worst things you can do as a bass player is like, you know, play too much, overplay, you know, be super complicated. You know, the best bass stuff is solid and supportive and mindful of everything going around it. You know, the bass is really that glue, you know, between the rhythm and harmony. So that's the worst in my opinion. That's the third worst in my list. Okay, the second, and I struggled with the second or the first, but I would argue is your tone. And I think back to, you know, some of the stuff, you know, I was reading about Miles, and he was like, really, him and so many other people, you know, just said, you know, all he had was his tone is what he would say. And maybe that's not a direct quote, but more or less he understood that, like, if you don't sound good, if the sound's coming out of your instrument do not sound pleasing, you've already lost your audience. You could have the best chops in the world. If you sound bad, if your tone isn't on, and I would include in that, like, for you fretless guys, like, if you're out of tune, you know, if you're playing a bass where the intonation is, like, out, and you're standing out, your bass is not even able to play in tune, like, that's problematic. Like, that's a deal breaker. You know, if let's say your instrument is set up that the action is so low that all you're getting is like rattling bass strings, and maybe that's the sound you want to go for certain kinds of music. Maybe you're into thrash and you want that, you like that, fine. If that tone works, great. But if you just, you don't put a lot of effort into, like, what does your tone sound like? What does your instrument sound like? You know, like, are you using your, you know, some of us bass players don't even use the tone and volume knobs. There's, like, so much there. you know, I more and more I play, I tend to roll off more and more of the treble, and you know, as I mature as a player, I just find that it's just, there's a better tone there. I don't like the super bright stuff. I don't, for me, that tone isn't, there's not a good aesthetic there. So tone, intonation, make sure your setup's good. Make sure your technique is giving you good tones, you know? You know, where you're plucking the notes and stuff. Spend the time to get a good sound out of your instrument. And then I would say probably the single most important one is time-based capabilities on your instrument. For a bass player, we need to be able to lock in rhythms. We need to be able to, like, maintain tempo. You know, it's not the worst thing in the world if you speed up or slow down a little bit, but what's really bad is if you're inconsistent in how you're landing on your downbeats. And I'm not suggesting, you know, you always have to land right on the downbeat, but if you're always like a little behind, like, try to maintain that feel, that rhythm, you know? You know, I would say if I was trying to give advice to somebody just picking up the bass, you know, I would tell them, like, start by playing really simple bass lines. Make sure that whatever you're playing, it feels like something you could dance to. If you can't dance to it, if it feels like you can't, it doesn't evoke any kind of like movement, you're probably doing something wrong. Rhythm, you know, it's just, it has to be, it really does have to be very like repetitive and consistent to start to feel a groove, you know. It's so important, like the most important thing. So yeah, don't play too much. Don't overplay. Listen to what other people are doing, okay? Get a good sound out of your instrument, okay? You don't need expensive equipment to get good sounds out of an instrument. And rhythm and time.